think it is. We were fishing along the rock. No, it's not Long Beach either. This is when we were fishing over here in the sloughs, right off the bay, in, right here in Northern California by San Francisco. As a matter of fact, there's Pittsburgh right in the background. No, fishing's not too good along here. You lose more line and you lose more weights and everything else and hooks in these rocks, and it's actually worth it as far as I'm concerned. And I don't believe we'll come back over here anymore to fish. It's a good sport, it's a lot of fun, but shucks, who wants to keep losing leaders and all their baits and everything else? Now this this along here is Long Beach, California. We took part of this film I'm mistaken in the first place. This, I was right the first time. This is Long Beach. I remember now a few Ida's relatives here. We did go on a similar fishing trip in San Francisco along the sloughs, and that's the reason I was getting mixed up with the two. However, as I said before, it's still a pastime. There's a ship in the distance there, a tanker, probably headed for the oil tanks and dump their fuel. Nice and blue along here. It's clear, surprisingly clear, with all the ships out here dumping their refuge and everything else. There's the breakwater there. As I said before, now this is Long Beach actually. We made a similar trip along the sloughs in San Francisco, but there's Ida's cousin, I believe. Recreation vehicle parking center for Disneyland. A lot of recreation vehicles here. How about that? Looks more like a vehicle sales lot. There's thousands of vehicles here. And, have you ever been in a submarine looking at the underwater creatures? Well, here we are. As you can see the fish, and there's a large turtle, extremely large turtles here in the area. And, well, here we are above water now. And, here we go on the cruise. We're back at Disneyland one more time. As I said before, I sure have this film going from jumping from one place to the other in a hurry, don't I? Anyways, that's to cut out the monotony a little bit more, I guess. We're going to go take a cruise here down the river in one of these showboats here, whatever you want to call it. It's supposed to be an African safari is what it's supposed to be, although I haven't seen too many animals just yet. This was taken inside of the tunnel. It's pretty doggone dark. All you can see is a fire in the background. Supposed to be a few weird things going on in here also. There was a quick flash. There was something behind it, but I couldn't make out what it was. I think it's a ghost of some kind. There it is again. There's no relic of a ship. Just loaded down. Look at the people on her. Boy, she's just loaded right down. It's an old sailing vessel, and using it here as a show. And also they take them on a little tour around the lagoon here. And just to give me a feeling of what it felt like. Now here's a ferry boat. It's one of the first ferries built and renovated. They use it here constantly all day long. And it's a triple decker. They used it just like they used in the olden days, in the Wild West days, when they had shows on them and everything. They still have shows on them. Coming into the dock right now. There's a safari again down below. Some of the I believe we're up on top of the I forget what they call it, but it sure is a pleasant ride. There's supposed to be a whale's den, a storybook lane, that's what it is. People swarm here to Disneyland right and left by the millions every day. I sure like to get about 1 hour's intake on this. Somebody just went down there, zooming down there off the tracks into the water. There's the monorail. We took a ride on a monorail also, and it was sure fun. There's a submarine that we were on, and that's also quite a ride. They don't. None of them last too long, but they're still a pleasure to go on.
Well, here we are at Hoover Dam. My gosh, this is sure big. Construction workers. I don't know how many were killed when they were building this, but part of the project still in still being built. Anyways, there's a couple of lookout towers right there, and another one there in the background on the right-hand side. As you know, this place is in constant surveillance 24 hours a day. It's well lit at night and everything, so they can see what's going on. They have tours of the place to go down and look at the pumps and everything, but I don't think we have time for that now. They only do that twice a day. Anyways, this... It's quite a sight to see. There's a barge down there they use for repair work and troubleshooting, I guess, and also a catwalk there on the right-hand side they used to get around on. And as you can notice there, the water erosion along the bottom there kind of turns the white, the rock formation is white. I guess it cleans it or something. We'll zoom in there and see the Colorado River there, where it comes in around the canyon. And it's all part of the Colorado River project built right into it. Rock formations here are really beautiful. Some of it looks almost like lava rock, doesn't it? Anyways, doggone it, boy, this is sure huge. It's almost as big as the Grand Canyon when it comes right down to it, when you look at it from the top. We came in all the way around the canyon, or rather, all the way around the dam, rather. And there's my motorhome. Somebody left the door open. Ida's not here, so I guess maybe she's in there either cooking or getting ready to cook. Anyways, I started to say when you drive down here, you come all the way from the very top of the mountains, and you keep winding and winding and coming down and down and down. There's a souvenir shop here at Hoover Dam where you can buy almost any kind of souvenir you want, including some of the rock formation. If you want water, I guess you have to drink it.
Anyways, you come down from the top, and road keeps winding down, and by the time you get over here to where we're at, you drive completely around the dam itself. As you can see right there, there's a roadway that goes all the way around. Well, this is sure some project to see, all right. From the Grand Canyon now. Boy, we're sure bouncing around from one place to the other. How about that? There's Ida overlooking the Grand Canyon right there. We're on the south rim right now. And it sure is immense. When they say grand, they sure meant grand. Anyhow, you can't even imagine how large this actually is unless you're here in person. People right there, standing on the edge of the precipice here, or cliff, whatever you want to call it. But, anyhow, if you get a little too close to the edge, you actually get woozy, you actually get dizzy. And this is what Ida is so afraid of. I get within about, I'd say 6 to 10 foot from the edge. And she has just about, panics. As I said before, you get too close to the edge and you would probably fall over from dizzy spells. But 6 to 10 foot from the edge, shucks, what can happen? All you can do is fall on the ground. Somebody could probably come along and drag you back. But some of these people sure are taking unnecessary chances, I think. They get within about a foot and a half of the edge there, and maybe they get steadier nerves than I have. There's part of the Colorado River down there, I believe. It's at the bottom of the canyon. As you can see, there's all the different color formations. That's caused from the sun, and it's all natural. It is one of the greatest natural wonders of the world. There's Marie standing up there looking down, and David sitting down right there with the mother. Marie's naturally not too close to the edge. There's Marie's friend, and Bobby just walked by there. It actually looks like you're close to the edge from a distance, but it really isn't. There's a natural formation right there caused from the wind and the sun. There's pretty pink colors, greens, blues, you name the color, it's here, magenta. There's Bobby and Mommy again.
Salt Lake City, Utah. As you can see, I'm taking the panoramic view here. Right over there, I believe, is a salt mine. Right there is a processing plant, I believe. I don't know just which company it is, but at any rate, there it is. The only smog around here that I can see.
Anybody can actually.
There's plenty of motorhomes around the area and everything else. There's my motorhome right there. As you can see, there's Marie wiping her face. There's David there too. And there's the. Salt Lake right in the back. It's a very large place. There's Ida and the doorway. And there's the lake again. David right there. Cleaning up, he's just been swimming. There's sure a lot of people around here. You can do sailboating or anything around here. Well, I guess that's enough of the lake.